What's going on? I'm Marcus Fly for PBS Television, and we are here in an exclusive home in the hills of Baldwin. Baldwin Hills, I believe is what they call it, for the famed movie experience, 846 The Experience, celebrating some amazing work of Mario Van Peebles and, of course, Robert Townsend. So stay with us. This is going to be absolutely fascinating because we have thoughts about the movie, we have people who are actually in the movie, and we got lots of other stars. So hang in there.
Tell us a little bit about what you guys are doing and the films you all created and how this all came about.
It's an anthology feature film, protest film. After the death of George Floyd, we knew we needed to, you know, be a part of the protest, but not something that would stop.
Right.
So in a cinematic way, we brought 10 directors together to produce one film.
And that's what we have,
846. So we're promoting tonight, 846 The Experience. BENDOLL, IMB Foundation, it's a collaborative art form.
Wow. How did this project come about? Why did you decide to get behind it the way that you did?
I am telling you, that's a great question. Actually, when I came on, Denton, who is the creator of 846 the movie, we had a mutual friend.
Okay.
We had a mutual friend, and we talked, and he was telling me he was trying to get this project on its feet, and it kept failing. It was things that kept coming about that it just wasn't working.
Yeah.
And we prayed about it.
Okay.
We literally, we're both believers.
The right thing to do.
Right. So we prayed about it, and we were like, you know what, don't give up.
Right.
You can never give up on something this great, this cause, you know?
We have here one of the filmmakers today. How you doing?
How you doing? My name is Thomas H. Stewart, and I'm happy to be here.
Thomas, tell us a little bit about this film. This is the 846 Experience.
846 is a feature film with 12 different parts, directed and written by 12 different directors, all come together with one long feature film. It's an anthology. It's a beautiful piece. I can't wait to share it with the world, along with the rest of the directors.
Why is editing such an important process of filmmaking?
Because it's actually the final aspect of putting the story together. Because you can have parts that you shot, and it doesn't go in the order that you originally wanted it to.
Right.
You see something in editing, we can change this. Change one part and put it in another place, and it completely changes the story.
Tell us all about what's happening tonight.
Well, there is going to be a movie premiere for a phenomenal film. And what my goal tonight is to remind creators to create. There are things happening in our world to be talked about. And sometimes we can shape the view of audiences by simply creating something like this. So I'm super excited to be here.
I am. Well, you named it all because I am the writer, director, and actress of this short film, Unapologetic, in 846.
Tell us about, I know you can't tell us too much, has been given the word tonight.
Okay.
I'm surprised. However, can you tell us a little bit about your project, Unapologetic, in 846?
Absolutely. I am a spoken word artist as well as an actress. So when I was approached to do this particular piece, Unapologetic stood out to me because it said the word poetry in it. And I said, okay, that's me.
Wait to see all the things this film is about, but one of the things I'm excited about is that you're young. how can, especially with PBS, we have a segment where we're talking about filmmaking and filmmakers. How do we continue to get youth to be inspired to create stories like this?
The first thing is seeing people like myself and younger actually really working within this field and showing that it's very possible. You know, like if there's any one thing I've loved is that I feel like as Hollywood is starting to open the idea of diversity and building that up, and especially people like my age, like when I see like the Ryan Cooglers like out there actually doing stuff, and he's not that much older than me, and being able to see that really does make a difference.
Well, I am one of the writers, directors, my piece is called Eva's Protest, and it's about a young 10-year-old girl who is consciously awoke about everything that's happening in society, about the social injustice to people that look like her.
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Wonderful. I'm so glad to see you here. I'm so glad to look around this place and see a sea of excellence.
Yes.
So I'm here to support all of those slashers that we talked about,
right.
All of those writers, producers, directors, actors. I'm just here to support them tonight. So, and the, one of the executive producers and creators, Benji Wade, I'm definitely here to support him. But these people came together and made 10 films about us.
Yes.
So tonight, I believe it is our duty to make sure that we honor those fallen soldiers that we are here celebrating, and celebrating the fact that we're still here fighting.
What brought you out tonight? What's so important about you?
Well, you know, I was blessed to be given the opportunity to write and direct a segment of this anthology, and so I'm here to celebrate that, but also to support my peers, the other directors, the producers.
It's actually my directorial debut. I did Jane's Decision.
Okay, tell us a little bit. I know you can't tell us much. Tell us a little bit about Jane's Decision.
Jane's Decision is about a young woman who is biracial, and she goes home for a visit from college, and it's about her realizing that maybe her white side of the family isn't as open-minded to people of color as she thought they were.
I'm so blessed that I was asked to be a part of it, that I was chosen, and I feel like what I did, the role that I played, was very important for people to see, because it's not necessarily what you would feel like is the traditional way of thinking about some of the things that were happening. So I think it's important for people to see different perspectives about some of the things that were happening through that time.
Mm-hmm. Right here for Rise and Shine in the 846 Experience at this exclusive, amazing home right here in Baldwin Hills. This is a huge event because we're looking at the films, and of course, we're having a whole lot of fun with all these amazing, talented people. So hang in there and stay with us. We'll be back with so much more. Why? What brings you out tonight, brother?
Hey, man, I'm just excited to celebrate this amazing production, man. Like, my Denton Adams is my brother, the like creator and the director and so many things. So just to be out here supporting him and just like creating this, everybody support everybody a part of it, man. It feels good. Feels good.
Yeah. We're here at this tremendous, huge project. It's called 846 The Experience, all about this amazing film that's going to touch lives. We're here with?
Damien D. Lewis.
Damien, tell us a little bit about this project and what brings you connected to it.
This project is, of course, about the George Floyd situation. What brings me to it is one of my ex-students, Freddie Ramsey, as a writer-director of the film, called me up one day and said, hey, I got this piece I've been working on. I have a role that I would love for you to play. It's a detective role. It's also an encouraging role. It's a man of God. So would you be interested in playing? And I said, well, it sounds about right. Let me read the script. And once I read the script, I was all the way in. It's an honor to be a part of this piece.
What a day and night this has been. I can't tell you that there's been anything else less than excellent here tonight, right here at 846 The Experience. The Rise and Shine, I think we saw a lot of people who believe in just simply that. Rise and Shine to change the world for the better. I'm Marcus Fly for Rise and Shine on PBS. We'll see you next time.